With the trigger set up properly, our next step is to go into subscriptions, and we're going to define who gets to receive this particular notification. Now, you'll notice that there's integration here between Microsoft's Active Directory, so you can do a search through Active Directory to find, you know, Active Directory based users. Now, I'm going to show you in just a second how to configure a contact if you're not using Active Directory. So for example, I'm going to search for all the Active Directory users whose name begins with BO. I'm actually looking for Bob Smith. And as you can see here, this has gone through my Active Directory database. It's found the user Bob Smith. The way I add this user is I can click on his name and drag him over into subscriptions, or I can just drag this email into subscriptions, and that will indicate that this is going to be a of the different delivery channels for this user Bob Smith. Then we're going to choose email as the delivery channel in this case. So let me demonstrate. If I just drag his name and I drop it into subscriptions, you'll notice we get a list of all the different delivery channels. Well, in this case, Bob Smith only has one configured under his contact, so that's the one I'm going to use. Now, I could have done the same thing just by dragging this straight over. But if you were to configure this or reconfigure this, you could add other delivery channels for Bob Smith, and then you get to choose whether it's an email or whether it's a web service or some other type of delivery channel. So that has subscribed now Bob Smith to be receiving this notification via email. Now, when you're doing this back home, if it's the first time you've dragged Bob Smith's email over to a subscription, you'll see that an options dialog box appears. And this is where you can specify, for example, should he be notified on a close? In this case, I don't want him to be notified on a close. Is there a specific retry interval and a maximum number of retries, etc.? So those are some of the options available. Okay, so what if you're not using Active Directory at your site? Let me show you how you would do it. First, let me check this in. Again, we see that this needs to be checked in just to be on the safe side. And I'll go into Contacts, and I will create a brand new contact. Now, what you're going to notice is contacts are common throughout the entire AF, all the different databases in AF. What we're doing right now in notifications and elements are local to this particular AF database, but contacts actually spans all the different AF databases. So to create a new contact who's not in AF, I would go into this section here and choose New Contact. You can also do a right-click on this. And just give it a name. Give your contact a name. I'll say this is Ken Lee. And his email address, let's say it's klee@test.com. Now you'll notice in this Learning Lab environment, you don't have the ability to go outside the local environment for SMTP. So you're not going to be able to email yourself a notification. Anyway, I'll go ahead and check this in. And this becomes a brand new contact. So back in my notification, under CDT warnings, that's my notification under subscriptions. If I do a new search, you should be able to find, well, we'll look at all the Active Directory users plus any other contacts. You can see Ken Lee is a brand new contact, and I can drag this user over, drop him onto subscriptions. As you can see, it's the first time we've used him, so we get that dialog. And now he is a subscriber to this particular notification. Now, I know this is going to fail, so I'm going to go ahead and unsubscribe him. But you can go ahead and try it. It won't hurt anything. You'll just see error messages appear when the notification triggers. Well, that's it. We are finished. We haven't done any of the fancy stuff like add new content, but we'll do that later on. That's in the next exercise. All that needs to be done is to check this in, as we've done, and then to start this notification. Now, when you're doing this back home, double check to make sure that your notifications service is actually running before you try to start this. Now, to test this, there's a couple of things we can do to test it. The first thing we can do, we will have to trigger this so that the notification, in fact, is in place. Now, I can tell it's not in place now because if I go into history, I look for active instances. I don't see any active instances. I don't see any notifications. Or if I just look at the recent ones, I don't see any recent activity. Well, this one's just been created, so obviously there's nothing there. So in order to trigger this, what I need to do is go into the Py System Management Tools, and under PySMT, you'll see a data section. There's an archive editor. We can use that to force values into the Py system. So let me resize this so we can see the whole thing. Yeah, here it is. It's the data section. We're going to go into the archive editor. And we'll do a search for this tag. It was called, as I described it, the tag was called MyCDT158. Yeah, there it is. And if I retrieve the events, I can see there's really nothing in there. I'd probably have to go back more than 30 days or something to see anything in there. Okay, so we do have some information in there that's kind of old. Let's just go back 2 hours. And there's no data. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to put in a value of 250. And that's going to force this notification to fire. I'll go ahead and save. And then we should be able to go back and take a look at this notification and see if it becomes active. As you can see, we caught it right in time. This is now active. It's got the state that we chose, high, high. And we should see some notifications showing up in email soon. Now, I do want to point out something, just in case we didn't connect the dots here. This tag, MyCDT158, the reason this is the trigger is, again, if we go back and look at monitored tags, that element had an attribute called tag MyCDT158 that points to that tag MyCDT158. So this attribute is what we're using in the trigger, and it points to that tag. That's why we triggered the notification. Now, let's also verify this by taking a look at email. Now, we've tried to make it easy here in the Learning Lab environment to check Bob Smith's email. There is an option here. Yeah, there we go. You should see a bunch of little links, run Outlook as B. Smith. This is a nice little shortcut that simply runs Outlook using the run as mechanism, and it's going to log you in as Bob Smith. So if I double click on that, that should launch without the need for a password. It should launch Bob Smith's Outlook. And let's see if we've gotten anything. Yes, there we go. You can see if we look in today's email, here is the notification that was sent by CDT Warnings. It's a notification. We can acknowledge this using this acknowledge option or acknowledge with comment. Now, this is going to be available if you've configured a SharePoint server. And this is going to go out and there we go. It's going out to a website and warning me about a phishing filter. I'll turn that off for this demo. And there we go. Now we can go ahead and make a comment. Fake alarm for test. And I'll go ahead and acknowledge. So that's going to be part of the permanent record. And in any event, that's an example of how we can get an email notification and then acknowledge it from within Outlook. Now, another mechanism we could have used, if you don't see this run Outlook as B. Smith, one of the options you can do is within, if you're just looking at Outlook, if you hold down Shift and then do a right mouse click, you'll see a run as option. Then you can run it as Bob Smith. Or down at the bottom, just do a right click, do a run as, and then you can run this as Bob Smith. It's B. Smith is the name of the user. Now, if any of these users in the Learning Lab environment prompts you for password, use the password student. So this is going to log me in, and now I can take a look at his email. And finally, let's go revisit our notification in the Py System Explorer, and you'll see that that acknowledgement did show up as part of the permanent record. So we can see we resent the message every 2 minutes, as we said. And we're going to be resending this every 2 minutes, and then we got an acknowledgement.